I wonder what he's saying, Hillary. Probably, I think I'm worth £50,000 after that sale last year, you remember?
It was an extraordinary event to have a teddy bear fetching £50,000.
Yes.
And I don't think we'll ever see the like again, certainly not for many, many years.
You think that was a one-off, do you?
I think it was. Of course, all teddy bears to their owners are absolutely priceless.
Yes.
And it's just that it doesn't always follow through in the auction market. And I know that some people have bought bears for quite a lot of money in markets and book fairs and so on, thinking that they've found a bargain. But you still have to be just as careful with teddy bears as you do with any antique and find out about the subject before you start investing.
Now, what about these fellas here? There's nothing in the £50,000 bracket.
Well, I mean, altogether, they probably wouldn't make even £1,000, I'm afraid.
Yeah, sorry, chaps.
What's nice is that they've all been loved to a greater or lesser extent. They're all a bit bored as a result. But nothing here, I'm afraid, that's going to set the teddy bear collecting world alight.
So are you disappointed with that? Yes.
This is a really quite outstanding little group of stuff boxes that you brought along here. Are you a collector of them?
No, they're just family inheritance.
Really?
But, you know.
And they've been in the family for quite a long time,
haven't
they?
Well, since the middle 30s, I think.
Oh, right.
So,
because most of them are French, and the actual period of most of them is around 1780.
Oh, as early as that.
Yes, and there's a variety of techniques involved. This is a very fine box made in Paris, and from the hallmark one can see that it was made in 1784. They quite obligingly put a little 84 in the middle of the letter P. Now, the hallmarks on French silver and gold are extremely complicated. There are thousands of little tiny marks, and sometimes they're quite obscure. But the Paris ones are fairly easy to understand. And in order, here you have the maker's mark. You have the tax mark, which shows that the thing had been, the tax had been paid on it. And you have what's called the Poinçon de la Maison Commune, which is actually the guild of Paris goldsmiths, to make sure that the gold is of the correct standard, 18 carat. The technique is enamelling. Here, translucent pink enamelling over beautifully engine-turned background. Here, painted enamelling, and it's a very popular subject, sacrificing at the altar of love. Enamel borders. It actually appears to be a bit damaged here, but I just want to give it a little... No, it's just dirt.
Just plain dirt.
That's actually in perfect condition. I was going to say that the value was much depreciated by the damage to the enamelling, but in fact it's perfect. That's the underneath. It's really beautiful. A lovely box.
What, was it a snuff box or just a box?
It was a snuff box, and these things were often luxury presents from one wealthy person to another, a little thank you for favours or a little perhaps bribe in anticipation of a favour.
Yes, yes.
I don't specialise in these boxes, but I imagine that the value of this is probably something in the region of £10,000.
I almost forgot this. a very fine quality continental porcelain vase in the style of Sèvres. Not Sèvres.
No, it isn't.
But, no.
Oh.
Sèvres never made anything quite like this, but many people in the 19th century did Sèvres-style objects. Mm. At one time, I would have dated this probably in the 1860s and 1880s, but I'm now revising that. I think these are much earlier, and I think this is about 1830 to 1840. Would have been a pair originally.
It is a pair.
It's still a pair.
It is a pair.
Oh, good. In good condition?
Yes. I mean,
got a knot
cracked
there.
Tiny, slightly damaged top, but I mean,
yeah, that otherwise it's fine.
A slight chip, but I mean, the actual.
Well, the painting here is so good. I mean, we've got a nice harvesting scene with a girl and a dog here. Well, very good subject. Nice jewelling, in good condition, basically, and a pair like that, very saleable. And given even that damage, I think somewhere around 1,800 to £2,500. Pleased?
Oh, I'm absolutely staggered.